ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय।
ओम नमो भगवते
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Reading from Srimad Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter 4. Today we are going to cover three slokas, 28, 29 and 30. So first slokas I will recite, you can repeat. The last two slokas, 29 and 30, I will alone recite. So please repeat after me. Dravya-yajnas,
dravya-yajnas,
tapo-yajnas, yoga-yajnas,
yoga-yajnas,
tathapare,
tathapare,
svadhyaya-yajnas,
svadhyaya-yajnas,
svadhyaya-jnana,
svadhyaya-jnana,
yajnascha,
yajnascha,
yatayah,
yatayah,
samsita-vratah,
samsita-vratah.
Dravya-yajnas, tapo-yajnas,
dravya-yajnas, tapo-yajnas,
yoga-yajnas, tathapare,
yoga-yajnas, tathapare,
svadhyaya-jnana-yajnas,
svadhyaya-jnana-yajnas,
yatayah, samsita-vratah,
yatayah, samsita-vratah,
dravya-yajnas, tapo-yajnas,
dravya-yajnas, tapo-yajnas,
yoga-yajnas, tathapare,
yoga-yajnas, tathapare,
svadhyaya-jnana-yajnascha,
svadhyaya-jnana-yajnascha,
yatayah, samsita-vratah,
yatayah, samsita-vratah,
dravya-yajnas, tapo-yajnas,
dravya-yajnas, tapo-yajnas,
yoga-yajnas, tathapare,
yoga-yajnas, tathapare,
svadhyaya-jnana-yajnascha,
svadhyaya-jnana-yajnascha,
yatayah, samsita-vratah,
yatayah, samsita-vratah.
Yoga-yajnas, tathapare, yoga-yajnas, tathapare, yatayah, samsita-vratah, yatayah, samsita-vratah,
Yoga-yajnas, tathapare, yoga-yajnas, tathapare, yatayah, samsita-vratah, 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 yatayah, samsita-vratah Sloka that year. Sarve kiye te yenge vidho, yenge chapita kalpasaha, yenge shishta vrata bhujo yati brahma sanatanam. Dravya-yajnah. Please repeat after me.
Dravya-yajnah.
Sacrificing one's possessions.
Sacrificing one's possessions.
Tapo-yajnah.
Tapo-yajnah.
Sacrifice in charities. Austerities.
Sacrifice in austerities.
Yoga-yajnah.
Yoga-yajnah.
Sacrifice in eightfold mysticism. Tatha, thus, apare, others,
svadhyaya,
sacrifice in the study of the Vedas, jnana-yajnah,
sacrifice
in advancement of transcendental knowledge,
sure.
Also, yatayah,
enlightened persons,
samsita-vratah,
taken to
strict vows.
Translation
and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Having accepted strict vows, Some become enlightened by sacrificing their possessions, and others by performing severe austerities. By practicing the yoga of eightfold mysticism or by studying the Vedas to advance in transcendental knowledge. Still others who are inclined to the process of breath restrain to remain in trance, practice by offering the movement of the outgoing breath into the incoming and incoming breath into the outgoing, and thus at last remain in trance, stopping all breathing. Others, curtailing the eating process, offer the outgoing breath into itself as a sacrifice. All these performers who know the meaning of sacrifice become cleansed of sinful reactions, and having tasted the nectar of results of the sacrifice, they advance toward spiritual supreme eternal atmosphere. I will read 30th sloka purport alone, because other purports are very huge. Purport of 30th sloka. From the foregoing explanation of different types of sacrifice, namely sacrifice of one's possessions, study of the Vedas or philosophical doctrines, and performance of the yoga system, it is found that the common aim of all is to control the senses. Sense gratification is the root cause of material existence. Therefore, unless and until one is situated on a platform apart from sense gratification, there is no chance of being elevated to the eternal platform of full knowledge, full bliss and full life. This platform is the eternal atmosphere or Brahman atmosphere. All the above mentioned sacrifices help one to become cleansed of sinful reactions of material existence. By this advancement in knowledge, not only does one become happy and opulent in this life, but also at the end he enters into the eternal kingdom of God. Either merging into the impersonal Brahman or associating with the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. So please repeat after me, translation.
Having accepted
strict vows,
some
become enlightened by sacrificing their possessions, and others by performing
severe austerities,
by practicing the yoga
of eightfold mysticism,
or by studying the Vedas
to advance in
transcendental knowledge.
नमो ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी विनामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी भाषाद्य देशदारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्त वृंदा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे हरे
Hare Krishna. Welcome to this Sunday program at our Surabhi Kunj Bhakti Sadhan Center. Today we are going to discuss from chapter 4, which is called Transcendental Knowledge, and three slokas together, sloka 28, 29, 30. So in sloka 28, so if you see, there are the same words repeating again and again, yengyaha, yengyaha, yengyaha. So Krishna explains about various types of sacrifices or spiritual methods which are approved by Lord Himself. One is strict vows, following different types of vows. Second is sacrificing the possessions, giving away everything. Third, severe austerities. And fourth, Krishna explains about the Ashtanga Yoga process, practicing the yoga of eightfold mysticism. And in the same sloka last, the Krishna explains about studying the Vedas, going through the Vedas to advance in spiritual knowledge. And in the subsequent sloka, Krishna says, again it is like an expansion of eightfold yoga system, it is called hatha yoga. So Krishna explains about the breath control. Controlling the breath and remaining in trance in remembering the Supreme Lord form, trying to remember the Supreme Lord form. And finally Krishna says, why we have to follow all this? So by performing this, what the performers are going to achieve. So Krishna concludes, performers knows the meaning of the sacrifice. One thing, the performer will get cleansed of the sinful reactions, and also the performer will start to taste the nectar of this spiritual process. So by following this spiritual process, the ruchi, what the soul is expecting, the soul will start to relish that ruchi, taste, which cannot be relished by the material senses. When the ruchi, the soul start to relish, definitely the soul will realize this is something different from the material platform. So Krishna, that's what Krishna says in 30th sloka, having tasted the nectar of the results of sacrifice, they advance toward the spiritual eternal atmosphere. So Krishna talks about various types of spiritual methods to follow, to advance in Krishna consciousness and to reach Him. Now, we are going to discuss how Prabhupada has already implemented this in our ISKCON system, and by following the rules and regulations prescribed by Prabhupada, how we can achieve the same results. Now, first we have to understand why these are not possible in this age. So Krishna says, right, by practicing the yoga of eightfold mysticism, right? So most of you might have heard this Ashtanga yoga. So what are the eight processes of Ashtanga yoga? Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. What is meant by Dharana? Yama means internal cleanliness. Yama, Niyama, internal cleanliness, external cleanliness, then breath control, then mind control, sense control, it goes various stages, right? What is meant by Dharana? Dharana, concentration, focus. See, since time immemorial, this soul has taken many births, right? In each birth, it has performed various types of sinful actions. Now, whenever I perform a sinful action or any action, okay, it will create an impression in the heart of the soul. That impression won't go so easily. It will, that impression also will follow the soul. It will exist in that mind of that soul for many births. It won't go so easily. So that impression will be there. So we have taken many births, and what we have done, we don't know. But still the impressions are there. That's why we are struggling in our spiritual life. Second thing, those sinful activities, it will produce sinful reactions. Also it will create many, it will give birth to many sinful seeds, which will sprout in the future. So now all of these are accumulated in our heart. Okay. Now having this, so many with this, and particularly after taking birth in Kali Yuga, which is completely disturbed, it's very difficult to focus. So Kurma Purana, one of the chapter talks about this yoga system. So in Kurma Purana, it is mentioned, you are all able to hear, right? So Kurma Purana, it says, if someone is able to not disturbed, get disturbed by any of these impressions, should overcome these mental impressions, all these mental thoughts, ignore everything, and if someone is able to focus on one object for 12 seconds, it is called dharana. So, the second, it depends on the soul. Suppose if I have taken 1000 births, then let's say I have lakhs of impressions, lakhs of thoughts. Everything is already there in my mind, okay? So I should be able to destroy all those impressions by devotional service. I should be able to overcome everything. I should not get disturbed by those. And after that, I should be able to, if I am able to focus 12 seconds on one object, it is called dharana. And if I am able to maintain 12 times of that 12 seconds, that is called dhyana, which means 144 seconds. 12 seconds if I am able to meditate on one object, okay, without getting disturbed by any of these impressions or desires, then it is dharana. 12 times of that dharana is one dhyana, which is 144 seconds. That is what called dhyana. And after practicing like that, if I am able to do 25 minutes and 10 seconds like that, continuously on one that same object, it is called samadhi. So to reach the level of dharana, a yogi practices yama, niyama, asana, pratyahara, pranayama for 15,000 years, 20,000 years, 25,000 years to reach this stage of dharana. So after that, the yogi further advances, then he reaches, the yogi reaches dhyana, then it's samadhi. Okay, so there are other vows out there, strict vows, studying the Vedas, all are various prescribed methods, okay, but in Kali Yuga, what in Srimad Bhagavatam first canto says, what is that sloka? Where, the sloka explains, right, what is the nature of persons who take birth in Kali Yuga? Bandha Subandha Matayo, what is the first line of the sloka? Okay, anyway. So, Mandaha Sumanta Matayo, Manda Bhakyaki Upadrutaha. In Kali Yuga, whoever takes birth, right? First thing, they will be always lazy. And second thing, they will not at all be interested in philosophy or spirituality. That thing, they are always misguided. Now, completely we are misguided, right? How many places we are saying bold? Meditation, free classes. Because they don't know what is meant by meditation. If they really know the meditation, they won't try to even think about that meditation. The meditation what they are teaching. So completely misguided. Okay, so having all these criteria, it's impossible to follow all these conditions. Now, second thing is this breath control. It is also a part of this Ashtanga Yoga only. Breath control. Okay. Krishna says, offering the movement of the outgoing breath into the incoming and the incoming breath to the outgoing. So, when I try to breathe, okay, so the lungs has to prepare, right? The lungs has to be ready to absorb oxygen and give away the carbon dioxide. So, both I have to control and to fix in my nostril. So, the incoming air I should allow, outgoing air also I should allow, and I should control both in my nasi, and I just focus in my nasi, this tip of the nose, and I should meditate on Vishnu, which is very difficult. How long I keep seeing like that? So, anyway, it is not possible without practice. So, that is also very difficult in this age. Because we don't have that mental strength as well as physical strength in Kali Yuga. So, now what is the ultimate purpose of all these practices? What is the ultimate purpose of all these various practices?
Senses.
First step is to control the senses. First step is to control the senses. Now, after controlling the senses, what is the purpose of controlling the sense? To control the mind. And final thing, final motive is to always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. Okay, the level of gopis is, they want to forget Krishna, but they cannot forget Krishna. Now, our stage is, we want to remember Krishna, but we cannot remember Krishna. Because impurity attracts impurity. Magnet attracts magnetic force. So, we have so much impurities, that's why anything related to impurity we can remember. But anything is pure, we cannot hold that form or qualities long in our mind. For example, daily we are seeing Radha Madhav, or every week we are seeing Radha Madhav. Just close your eyes and try to think about Radha Madhav's form. It's very difficult because our heart is not that pure to hold Krishna's form. So, to hold Krishna's form, we have to become pure in equal to Krishna. Then only we will be able to catch that form of Krishna. Anyway, remembering Krishna is not in our hands. That is also by the causeless mercy of Krishna it will happen. So, now, that's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna thought all this process, whoever is going to appear in Kali Yuga, it's very difficult for them to follow. So what is the easiest method? So Krishna appeared as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he introduced this Sankirtan movement. Of chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So it is said that Harinama Sankirtan. Not just Nama Sankirtan, Harinama Sankirtan. So, even this Harinama Sankirtan also, Before Prabhupada time, was supposed to chant 64 rounds. 64 rounds supposed to chant. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, spiritual master of Srila Prabhupada, he said, he made a comment, if someone doesn't chant, one doesn't chant 64 rounds, he is considered to be fallen. But to complete 64 rounds, it will take 8 to 9 hours. It depends on the person, how for each round, how long he takes. So, then Prabhupada, very mercifully, Prabhupada said, okay, minimum 16 rounds, but gradually you increase it to 64 rounds and hold a very tight in Krishna service. So, because Westerners, they were not able to chant even the 16. So, Prabhupada said, okay, at least you chant 16 rounds, but hold a busy in Krishna service. Because book distribution, preaching service, arati, these are also expansions of holy names. So, better engage your senses in that holy name, in various services. Gradually, when you get purified, you will get a taste to chant. Right now, early morning, in empty stomach, if I sit, I can focus, I can invest little concentration on my chanting. But when it's very hot, 2:30, 2 o'clock, where it's very hot and I will go outside and come back, somebody asks me to sit and chant and with focus, it's very difficult. But the real result of our devotional service is, anytime if I sit, I should be able to chant with taste. Okay. Now, this chanting process given by Mahaprabhu, okay, but it is not that this chanting process applicable only for Kali Yuga. So, we all know, how many of you read Bhagavatam regularly? So, one, here and there. Mataji is raising hands, okay. So, in Srimad Bhagavatam, 5th canto, Sukhi explains about the types of Naragalokas, hellish planets. So, after hearing that, Parikshit Maharaj lost the hope. So many hellish planets. If I step on a small insect, I have to get the reaction. I have to go to one kind of hell and I have to get the same punishment. So, if I keep seeing, cannot even count the sins each soul is making in this material world. So, where is the hope? So, then Sukhi told, okay, don't worry, I will tell one pastime, okay, where there was a Brahmana who performed countless sins, still he get delivered. So, then only after 5th canto and 6th canto, Sukadeva Goswami, he started explaining the pastimes of Ajamila. Now, to Sukadeva Goswami, who told this pastime? No. To Sukadeva Goswami, who described this pastime? No, Vedavyas compiled Srimad Bhagavatam. Sukadeva Goswami himself has mentioned whom he met and from whom he got this. From whom he got to know. Agastya Muni. It is there in last sloka. While like each chapter Sukarishi explains the glories and benefits. If I read certain chapter, what spiritual benefit I will get? If I read this chapter, what kind of benefit I will get? So like that, while explaining this Ajamila story, after explaining, Sukadeva Goswami explains, Sukadeva Goswami tells, when I met Agastya Rishi in near Malaya Hills, Agastya Rishi told this confidential pastime to me. So, okay, Ravana, and what happened? He saw one scene of low class man embracing a prostitute, and his mind immediately got polluted and contaminated, and he again contaminating the same thing. So thinking, feeling, willing, and it came into action. So finally he sent away his old parents as well as his wife, and he started living with that same prostitute itself. And like that, for 88 years, from the young age till the 88th year, he continued his life living with that prostitute, and to satisfy her, he started stealing, doing murder, killing, all kind of sinful activities he started doing there. Now, at the 88th age, He had a son of 4 years old. Imagine how lusty he should be. Okay. Now, the point is, Ajamila saw such scene only once. And immediately his mind got polluted and it dragged him completely away from that Vedic life. And 88 years. Okay. Maybe approximately, let's say, at the 20th year, he saw that scene. 21st to 88, it is 68 years, he lived completely in a sinful way. Now imagine our case, TV, cinema, mobile, notice board, advertisement board, everywhere, however the mind should not get polluted, exactly that same way we are having all those visions. Right? So, that is the reason Kali Yuga is very difficult to focus. Because again and again, we are pouring the contaminations into our heart by force and increasing the disturbance. So it's very difficult to focus. That is the reason Mahaprabhu introduced the method of having sound vibration. Because the sound vibration keeps, it goes into the heart and it will penetrate the heart and it will purify the heart. Okay, I will come back now. So we all know, Ajamila at the time of death, he uttered the holy name of Narayana. He purposefully didn't call Narayana, he called his son. Okay, it is fine. And finally, Yamadutas came, Vishnudutas came. Okay, so now we are not going to discuss detail about Ajamila, what he did all this life. What instruction Vishnudutas gave, how they glorified the holy name. Okay, it is mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam, 2nd chapter, starts from 13th sloka. So, Yamadutas are asking, this Brahmana Ajamila, what sin he has not performed? He has performed all types of sins. He had to take care of his old age parents. He didn't take care. And his wife was very chaste. He drove him away. And he started living with a prostitute. And he did all kinds of sinful reactions. Now he has to suffer many number of years in the hell. Okay, but still, why are you preventing us to take away him? So the Vishnudutas told to tell us what is meant by dharma, what is meant by adharma. So Yamadutas said, one who lives according to the Vedas, that is dharma. Whatever Veda says no, that is adharma. If Veda says we have to fast on Ekadesi, we have to follow that dharma. I cannot do Sunday, I am free, so I will fast only on Sunday. That is not dharma. Okay? Then Vishnudutas said, this Brahmana Ajamila, he sufficiently made atonement for all his sins by chanting once the name of Lord Narayana. So only once he chanted. So then Yamadutas asked, how come? Did he meditate on Supreme Lord Vishnu? No. He called his son, his purpose of his intention was to call his son because he was very much affectionate to his son. But still you consider that uttering the holy name to call someone will nullify all the sinful reactions. So then in 6 slokas, Vishnudutas, they describe the power of holy name. So first sloka. Prabhupada uses this sloka very often. Very often, right? So what is the first sloka? Any of you know? Bhagavatam 4th canto, 2nd chapter, 13th sloka. Sanketyam parihasyam va stopam helanam eva va vaikuntanam agrahanam ashesha agharam viduhu. Sanketyam and parihasyam. To call someone, if I utter the holy name, still it will have effect. Parihasyam, jokingly. Suppose I wear tilak. If some devotee wears tilak and gets into the office, so obviously the colleagues, not office, especially it will happen in college days. If some college boys are calling Krishna consciousness, they will wear tilak and they will enter the college. So the equal boys, they will make fun of them, right? Oh, this Govinda person has come. Hare Krishna person has come. So, like, during my school days, first time when I went to tilak, it was English exam. So I gave, the president told me, you should wear tilak and go. If you wear tilak, if you don't wear tilak, Maya will laugh at you. If you wear tilak, you can laugh at Maya. So he said, at least apply tilak. Okay, there were situations where you cannot wear tilak. Suppose if I go to Middle East country, I should not wear tilak. So there are some restrictions out there. So that president, temple president said, anyway, you are young boy, 16 or 17, just wear tilak and go. Okay, I said, no, in college, many will make fun of me, right? He said, okay, that we will take care of during the college. Now you go like that. So, when I went, that was the first day of my examination. So, the question, most of the boys, they didn't study well. And I entered the classroom with tilak, everybody said, Govinda, Govinda. So, they started making fun of that. We understood the result of our exam now itself. Govinda! So, and Vishnu Duda says, even if someone chants the holy name of Krishna, Parihasyamba, Sanketyam, Parihasyamba, just jokingly, still it will have effect. Sanketyam, Parihasyamba, Sthobam, Helanam, Evava. To address someone, especially you call Krishna, still it will have effect. And accidentally, if you chant, see, accidentally means sometimes we will be about to slip down and suddenly I will catch Krishna, like that I will chant. So, accidentally, if I chant, still it will have effect. Vaikuntha Nama Grahanam. So, these holy names are not part of Vishnu Dudas are telling, these holy names are not part of the syllables, not part of any language, mundane language in this material world. It is directly sprouts from the spiritual world. It will immediately make a link that soul with the spiritual world. And this is one sloka, 13th sloka. So what is 14th sloka? Anybody know? So first is Sankhetyam Parihasyam Va Sthobam Helanam Va Vaikunta Nama Grahanam Ashesha Agaharam Vidruhu. So the next sloka is Patitah, Skalitah, Bhagnah, Sandashtah, Taptah, Ahatah, Harikiti Avasenaha, Kumana Artho Yatanaha. Yatana means, if once we die, once we die, 99% of the souls, they will go, mostly they are going towards down, hellish planets, right? That is what Yudhishthira Maharaj is telling. 99, most of the souls are going towards Himalayam, place of hemorrhage. No one is going towards upwards. Every moment is going, some soul is going down. So when we, if we, according to my karma and desire, suppose if I have to go to Yamalok, then what will happen? After entering into Yamalok, right, I will get a special body called Yatana. So that body, they can beat, they can torture, anything, as much as possible, they will do the torture, still, I will not die. I will get more punishment and I will feel more pain. So that is called Yatana Sharira, Yatana body. So now Vishnu Dudas are telling, suppose if someone dies accidentally, patita means falling down, we walking on the street, all of a sudden I will slip down and I will hit on a stone and I will die. Patitaha, skalitaha, I will meet some accident. Bhagnaha, I will meet accident and all my bones will get broken and I will be going through immense pain. Patitah, skalitah, bhagnah, sandashtah. Suppose if I bitten by a snake or any kind of poisonous snakes or any kind of insects and I die. Okay. Tathah, if I get very high fever, jaundice, malaria, cholera, typhoid, any kind of high fever. And ahatah, if I injured by any weapon, it could be any type of weapon. So any type of death also if some person goes through. But before going through, last moment, if someone chants the holy names of Krishna, immediately they are absolved from entering into the hellish planets, even though they are sinful. So this is the second sloka which Vishnu Dudas are telling. Okay. Patitah, skalitah, bhagnah, sandashtah, taptah, ahatah, hari iti avasenah. Before having such accidental misfortune, suppose if the last action, if he has done of uttering the holy name, even though he might be sinful, again, that person won't enter into hellish planets. Now, third sloka.
Guru Namcha Lagu Namcha, Guru Nicha Lagu Nicha.
What is meant by Guru Namcha? Guru means heavy, Lagu means small. Suppose if someone does very heavy sinful activities, before dying he should undergo heavy atonement according to that sin. If I have performed lighter sins, I should go through lighter atonement process. Guru Namcha Lagu Namcha, Guru Nicha Lagu Nicha. Now, this holy name, if someone chants the holy names of Krishna, what will happen? That holy name will not consider whether the sin is heavy or light. Whether it will be heavy or light, immediately it will nullify the sinful reactions of the chanter. Guru Namcha Lagu Namcha, Guru Nicha Lagu Nicha. Okay, this is the third sloka. Now, fourth sloka, Vishnu Thudas explaining.
Tantai agani puyante tapo dana vratadibhi
tat hridayam tat api isha angri sevaya. Okay, so there are other activities by giving charity, by following certain types of vows. Many people will follow amavasya, paurnami vrat, right? So like that, there are some vrats are there which can nullify the sinful reactions. But Vishnu Dudas are telling, even though such Vedic rituals, it may nullify the sinful reactions, but still it will not approve the material desires of that person. Because I may come out of the sins, but still the desire is there in my heart, right? Till the time that ignorance exists in my heart, I will keep doing the same mistake. See, an elephant, what it will do? It will get into the water, it will play as much as possible, but the moment the elephant enter into the land, whatever is possible, plants, leaves, stone, gravels, everything it will take and it will pour on its head. So similarly, it's called Kunjara Shauchar, taking elephant bath. So similarly, I might be performing various types of vows and I might be able to come out of sinful reactions, but still that sinful propensity has not gone. The root cause of the sinful propensity is the contaminations, material desires. So Vishnu Dudas are telling, tat api isha angri sevaya, one who serves the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord and chants this holy name of Krishna, only they can give away these material desires. So that process will uproot the material desires from their heart. And what is the fifth sloka?
Anyana athava jnana.
It means, knowingly or unknowingly, if someone chants the holy name, okay, it is like there is a dry grass is available, some person fires it, lights the fire on the grass, immediately the dry grass will catch, fire will catch that and the dry grass will burn to ashes. So like that, whether knowingly or unknowingly, if someone chants the holy names of Krishna, what will happen? Not only the sinful reactions will burn to ashes, also that material desires will be burned to ashes. Anyanat athava jnanat uttama sloka namayat. Uttama sloka, the holy names of Krishna, uttama sloka namayat, immediately it will burn to ashes. Dahet yato analaha. Analaha, that fire, like fire burns the grass into ashes, immediately it will burn the sinful reactions and material desires, ignorance. And last sloka, it is wonderful sloka, Vishnu Dudas are telling.
Yata kadam viryatamam.
Akada means medicine. Suppose a person is infected by a certain type of disease. Now that person supposed to take a medicine. Whether that person knows the potency of that medicine or not, it doesn't matter. Still the medicine will work. Because that medicine does not care whether the patient is aware of the potency of that medicine. Okay, similarly, this holy name, it is not going to care whether the person who is chanting, whether that person is aware of the potency of the holy name or not. It doesn't matter. Okay, Kuryan Mantropi. Like Kuryan Mantropi means, whether the chanter who is chanting the holy names, it doesn't matter. He chants, the holy name will react on him. What reaction? It will nullify the sins and it will also uproot the material desires. Immediately, it will start to pull that person towards Krishna. So in these 6 slokas, there is 2 more additional sloka, but it is long process, long sloka, so I am not reciting. So like that, Vishnu Dutas, they are glorifying holy names of Krishna. Now imagine the condition of Ashamila. So Vishnu Dutas are here, Yama Dutas are here, Yama Dutas are arguing with Vishnu Dutas, and Vishnu Dutas are answering to Yama Dutas, and they didn't tell any philosophy. They just explained only about the glories of holy name. And finally, they helped Ajamila not to enter into hellish condition of life. And finally, when Ajamila was about to speak something to Vishnu Dutas, Vishnu Dutas left. Then Ajamila realized what kind of sinful person I am. He started weeping and crying. And finally, he left the home, he went to Haridwar, and then he started meditating on the Supreme Lord. Finally, he went back to Godhead. So in the same chapter, last sloka, it is explained, Mriyamano Harinama Ghanan Putropa Charitam. Mriyamano Harinama Ghanan Putropa Charitam. Ajamilo Api Agathama Kim Putta Sraddhaye Ghanan. Mriyamano, at the time of that, Ajamila chanted once the holy name of Narayana, not with intention to call Narayana, to call his son, but still, nevertheless, Ajamila went back to Godhead. He went back to Godhead. So, Kim Uta Shraddhaya Jnanam. Suppose, if your person, with faith and without any offense, whole life, if someone utters the holy names of Krishna, then where is the doubt that he will go back to Godhead? There is no doubt on going back to Godhead. Definitely the Lord will help. So now, that is the reason Chaitanya Mahaprabhu thought, let me introduce a very simple process. Even the simple process also, Kali Yuga souls will feel very difficult. Right? So, now, in Hare Krishna movement, in Krishna consciousness movement, Prabhupada introduced this chanting of, not Prabhupada introduced, Prabhupada prescribed to, actually Prabhupada, first Prabhupada asked to chant 64 rounds only. Since Westerners, they were not ready to do, so finally Prabhupada agreed, okay, at least come to the level of 16, but 16 is only minimum, it is not the maximum. Maximum is whole day we have to chant. Okay, suppose if I am not able to chant, then I should ready to engage myself in service. Okay, now why we are discussing this? See, the purpose of this purport as well as sloka, Krishna tries to explain there are several methods which a person, a spiritualist has to follow. The ultimate goal is to come back to me. Okay, now because now we are in Kali Yuga, these whatever methods Krishna is prescribing, though it is approved, but we are not in a situation to follow. Okay, now the simplest way to follow is chanting of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is the simplest method Krishna gives, and it is approved by Acharyas. Okay, now why to chant Hare Krishna? There are many holy names out there, right? It is mentioned as Harinama Sankirtan. It is mentioned as Harinama Sankirtan, but why to pick Hare Krishna? Because Krishna himself came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and he insisted we should pick Hare Krishna. Second thing, Hare refers to internal potency of the Lord, Radha Rani. And Krishna refers to his Krishna, Rama refers to? No, again Krishna only. Rama also refers to Krishna. Okay, so I was going through another book. There is a book called Mukunda Mala Stotra. It is Mukunda Mala Stotra. It is sung by Kulashekara, King Kulashekara, Kulashekara Alwar. So King Kulashekara, who is King Kulashekara? Alwar. Alwar, okay. What is the meaning of Alwar? If you say Alma, then I will ask what is the meaning of Alma.
Vaishnavites who were practicing poetry in the form of devotion. Devotion is poetry.
No, not exactly.
Sir, merit their praising God, Krishna.
Okay. Please sit, Prabhu. You can sit and tell the answer.
Every minute there are Lord Krishna.
Okay. Actually, one answer what you told is correct. One who is deeply drowned in the ocean of devotional service to Krishna. Another is one who controls his heart by his unalloyed devotion. Two meanings are there. In English we don't have la la. In Tamil we have, in Malayalam we have. So according to la la, the meaning will differ. But both meanings are accepted. Okay, so Kim Kulashekara, actually he is an ornament of Lord Krishna. Ornament of Lord Krishna, he appeared in this material world then 5000 years before. 5000 years before, and in his old age, like daily, he used to think, at least today I should go to Srirangam. So what he will do, in which direction the Srirangam is there, in that direction he will walk four steps, or few steps, and he will pray to Jagganath, today I am walking few steps. One day I should walk more steps, more steps, more steps, and finally I should come there and I should eternally serve you. It is not only Sri Lanka, he was also deciding to go to Goloka Pradhan. Okay, so that King Kulashekara, he has composed a song called Mukunda Mala Stotra. He came to Sri Lanka, his daughter also came along with him, and his daughter, she got the taste of gopis. Whatever Mahalakshmi Devi, whatever service Mahalakshmi Devi was doing, that same taste her daughter got. And she married Jagannath and she went back to Godhead. So now he is alone. So what he can do? He wanted to offer a garland. Now he is a mendicant, renunciate, right? Then he will go for money. So with his pure devotion, he wanted to establish the importance of Nama Sankirtan, Harinama Sankirtan. So then he returned this stotras called Mukunda Mala Stotras. So he returned 53 verses. So someone will say it is 40 verses, some Vaishnavas will say 53 verses. So what is the original number, even I don't have idea. But in ISKCON book we have 53 slokas. So he returned those slokas and he offered it as a mala to Lord Mukunda. Okay, now in that he mentions about chanting the holy names of Krishna. Okay, so around 50th sloka he says, alam 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 eka praninam patakanam nirasana visheya krishna krishneti vani yat bhavati mukunde karatala kalita sa moksha samrajya lakshmihi. Okay, alam alam alam, enough enough enough, this single mantra which contains krishna 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 krishneti vani. Okay, that mantra which contains Krishna, Krishna, that one mantra, that holy name is enough to drive away the sins of all living entities. If someone chants with pure devotion, okay, either clapping hands or with kartal, okay, what will come? Worldly influence, karatala kalita sa, karatala kalita, either by hand or with kartal, three things will follow him. Moksha, samrajya, lakshmi, moksha, liberation. Worldly influence, samrajya, worldly influence, and lakshmihi, the required wealth to expand this preaching. Now what Prabhupada did? Prabhupada went to West. Okay? Prabhupada was not a professional singer, right? He was not singing like that, right? Prabhupada went to Tompkins Square Park. And what Prabhupada did? Took the kartal, or either by clapping, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So what Prabhupada did? Prabhupada just chanted Krishna Krishneti Vani. Prabhupada chanted purely what followed him, Moksha Samrajya Lakshmihi, the worldly influence. The wealth required for this expanding this Krishna consciousness movement and liberation. Prabhupada is already liberated soul, but whoever came in contact with Prabhupada, everybody started getting liberated. There are videos available where devotees passed away while hearing holy names. There are videos available. And there are even many past times happened also. And one of the devotees in Russia, he was in coma stage. And I heard from one of the senior devotees, I don't know the devotee name. He was a brahmachari. He was bedridden and he went to coma. He is supposed to die. So doctor said the pulse rate is going down. So he may die soon. Make the proper arrangements. Suddenly he got up. And he said, there were other devotees were there. And suddenly it seems that he said, whatever Prabhupada told, if someone chants Hare Krishna, it won't go in vain. At the end, definitely Krishna will personally take care of that soul. Whatever he told, it is true. And finally he left them. He left his body. So it happened. I heard from a sannyasi only. Some senior devotee I heard. Okay. So now Mukunda Mala Stotra, it is proved, right? Karatala Kalita Sa Krishna Krishneti Vani. One who chants Krishna Krishna, that mantra, okay, clapping the hands or playing the kartal, worldly influence, moksha, samraja, lakshmi. That will definitely, these three things will follow that person. So that is what Prabhupada proved. And Prabhupada likes this Mukunda Mala Stotra very much. There is one more sloka in Mukunda Mala Stotra where Kulashekara Alvar says, samsarochena mantram shakalam upanishad vakya sampurna mantram samuchita tamasaha sanga nidhyana mantram sarva aishwarika mantram vashana bhujaka sandashta santrana mantram jitpe sri krishna mantram japa japa satatam janma sapalya mantram. This is Kali Yuga. Don't go behind this world meditation, this process, yoga process, ashtanga yoga process. Don't go behind that. There is a mantra which mainly, primarily carries the holy names of Krishna. Chant constantly. Jipe Sri Krishna mantram, japa japa satatam. Continuously chant, continuously chant. Only that mantra can help you in this. That mantra can release you from the material pangs and take you back to Godhead. No other method will help you in this Kali Yuga. So he established the importance of Harinama Sankirtan and glorification of holy names of Krishna. So that is called Mukunda Mala Stotra. So that book is available. Prabhupada has written purport for few slokas. So in that sloka he says, Jikve Sri Krishna Mantram, Japa Japa Satatam. Continuously chant, don't stop. Anytime Maya can come and pick you. It's very difficult to maintain our consciousness. So chant, chant, chant and go back to Godhead. So this is about a holy name mentioned in Mukunda Mala Stotra. So similarly, we all know this pastime. When Vamanadev raised his leg and he measured the entire world. And finally he pushed Bali Maharaja to which loka? Sutala. And which leg Vamanadev lifted?
Right
leg. Left leg. Anyway, it is only two. So, left leg he lifted, right? And after he lifting, he pierced the outer layer of the cosmos and finally Ganges came down, right? So now, after doing that, he pushed it down Bali Maharaj to Sutala Loka. So after doing that, now Sukracharya is a Brahmana, right? Obviously, it is not good to make a Brahmana upset. So then, Vamanadev, he went back to Sukracharya to pacify him with sweet words. Because he is an elderly guru and Brahmana. So he didn't want to offend. So after speaking to Sukracharya, Sukracharya said, Mantratas Tantratas Chiddam. Any process without accompanying the chanting of holy names, it is a fold. Definitely it will have a fold. What? In Kannada, what you will say? What? Right? Fold. Not yet. So Shukracharya says, the best process is chanting the holy names of your lordships. So even if I perform any Vedic sacrifices, rituals or any types of Vedic rituals, but unless it also accompanies the chanting of holy names, then that process will not be considered as a complete process. Who is telling? Sukracharya. Sukracharya, the spiritual master of demons, rakshasas and yakshas, right? Daityas. So he says in Bhagavatam, it is there in Bhagavatam, Okay. The beauty of our Sunday lecture here is I can tell the chapter name, incorrect chapter name and incorrect sloka. Still nobody will question me. Because nobody speaks Bhagavatam. So anyway, it is there in Bhagavatam. So after, and Shukracharya, in few slokas, Shukracharya gives the explanation and the potency of the holy name. And finally he says, any process. So that's why even when we do marriage ceremony or any kind of ceremony in Kali Yuga, the other mantras will have very less power. It will not be much effective. So devotees in ISKCON, usually what they will do, the time, at the time of when the bridegroom ties the knot to the girl, so devotees used to chant, they used to do a small kirtan. Still devotees will do a small kirtan. So that will bring the real auspiciousness into the couple's life. Because the purpose of marriage itself to together to follow this Krishna consciousness. Okay, so this is the potency of holy name. And Prabhupada has given, Mahaprabhu has made a simple way to chant the holy names, and very quickly we can progress. And what Prabhupada has done, if I chant 64 rounds, what kind of spiritual benefit I have to get? He compassed that benefit and he has agreed to give us in our 16 rounds. So those who are chanting one round, please increase to 2 or 4. Those who are chanting already 16 rounds, they should without fail complete their 16 rounds. Because those 16 rounds, in Parpat, Prabhupada clearly says, not in this Parpat, in other Parpat of Bhagavatam, Prabhupada clearly says, unless the soul daily comes in contact with the Supreme Lord through the holy names, the soul cannot get purified. See, the soul has to get purified. So which is the easiest method? The soul, Supreme Lord is there, the soul is there. Now, the holy names are non-different from Krishna, so the soul has to keep in contact with the holy names so that the soul can get purified very easily. See, at the time of death, remembering Krishna is very difficult. Remembering Krishna is not so easy. It has to happen only by the special mercy of Krishna. Now, at the time of remembering Krishna is very difficult. Okay, it is almost impossible. But chanting the holy names of Krishna is very easy, because it involves only movement of my lips and tongue. Okay. Now, chanting the holy names of Krishna, in one day it is equal to remembering of Krishna. So remembering of Krishna becomes very easy. You all got it, right? Remembering of Krishna is very difficult, not possible. But chanting the holy names of Krishna is easy. Chanting the holy names of Krishna, in one day it is equal to remembering of Krishna. So remembering of Krishna is easy. A equal to B, B equal to C, C equal to D, so A equal to D. Okay, so I will stop the class here, because we have a few more announcements on book distributions, as well as small announcements how to increase the book distribution this year, and various strategies Kripamaya Prabhu is going to share. So I will stop the class here. If any questions, yeah.
So that Vishnudatak, on the whatever they have on the instruction, those are specific to at the time of death we should take the name, because even if it's accidentally, but that should be at the time of death only, right? Because if in general life we take how it will happen.
See, that is what in general life, last sloka. Okay, Prabhu's question is, Vishnu Dutas, they gave instructions, they glorified the holy names, right? So in the second sloka they said, Patitaha, Skalitaha, Bhagnaha, Sandashtaha, Taptaha, Ahataha. Like before any accidental misfortune I undergo, before that, suppose if I chant, I will not enter into the hell. Now your question is, that is at the time of death, but before death, like in the whole life, I might have chanted many times. So will it have any effect? That is your question?
No, I mean, that should not be impacted, you know, if we are doing accidentally also. That actual impact has to happen when the person is chanting at the time of death. Then only that all those effect will happen.
No. It is not mentioned that way. At the time of death, if you chant, you can go back to Godhead. Before death, suppose if you chanted holy names of Vishnu, intentionally you might be calling someone. your relatives are someone. But still, if you chant that, and finally if you end up in such accidents, what will happen is you will not enter hellish planets. At the same time, you won't go back to Godhead.
Oh, I think his question is, what will you do in death? You should chant the name. But when you die,
No.
I'm asking why you chant immediately, so that when you die, then it becomes a song.
No. His question is, at the time of death, if I chant, there is an effect. He is asking, before death I am chanting, but at the time of death I am thinking something else. Right? I chanted Krishna. Now the next moment, okay, suppose some bricks fall on my head. Now I am thinking, if someone is doing any harm to my car or bike, now I am dying. Okay, now what will happen? Almost similar, right? So now Vishnu Dudas are telling that person immediately absolved from entering into hellish planet. He may not be able to go back to Godhead, but he won't enter into hellish planet even though he is a sinful person. Then what will happen? So the Lord will arrange that soul to enter into some womb of another mother where he can practice devotional service. You understood?
I want to answer that question for it.
Yeah.
Actually, there is a discussion between Ramanacharya and Madhuraj. He's posing that Madhuraj answers for Ramanacharya, because one of the questions that Ramanacharya Krishna must ask, because Madhuraj says, I'm not answering that question because he's not serving me. If you are serving me, I'll answer you. One of the questions is, right now I'm able to remember you. At the time of death, if I'm not able to remember you, what will happen? The Lord said, if my devotee remembers me all through his life, at the time of death, I will remember him. If he not remember him. We have to think what the Lord has said, right?
Yeah.
The Lord will actually think about it. We should not actually think about death right now. What we can do right now is what we can already think about.
No, your question, your answer is correct, Prabhu. Ramanujacharya asked this question, Varadaraja, Lord Varadaraja said, but that is for fully surrendered devotees.
Yes, but what we can do right now, you know that.
No, his question is, a person is simple.
But him also the same answer will want to go. He can go back to Godhead. If he does, what he can do right now, but he can do Ramacharya. We are like squirrel, we are like Hanuman. But as a squirrel, you do what is the best for you. That's all you have to think about. Never compare us with anybody else. Each of us are individual. Each of us have a relationship with Krishna separately. So, Krishna knows what is good for us, but you do what is the best you can do right now. For example, right now, month of marathon.
That's all you can do right now. Do nicely.
Krishna will know what has to do at the time of death. You don't know
anymore
how you are
going.
Otherwise, this process is so simple. You don't plan
your
death at all.
Krishna
will plan
your
death.
Prabhu,
what's
the answer, Prabhu?
Prabhuji, better to talk in
mind. Yeah, I will repeat. See, Prabhu was telling the same question. Ramanujacharya also raised to his guru. So Ramanujacharya cannot talk directly to Lord Varadaraja. So his spiritual master went to Lord Varadaraja and asked him, now I am chanting, I am performing devotional service. But at the time of death, one thing I don't know when I am going to die. Okay, now at the time of death, suppose if I don't remember you, what will happen? So Varadaraja said, I will personally take care of you. I will remember that person and I will take care of that person. So Prabhu says, let us not worry about death. Okay, right now, what best we can do for Krishna. Suppose if it is the month of Kartik, engage others also in offering lamb. Now this is the month of Marathon. So let us try to distribute books and please Prabhupada. So now Krishna knows what is best for us. So let the Lord decide what is best for us, and definitely the Lord will also give best for us. No need to clap for everything.
One more question. So he said that a Krishna Nam has to be added. So any mantra which is having Krishna Nam, like Tukaram Maharaj was chanting Jai Jai Ram Krishna Hari. So is that any name with Krishna in it, that is?
Nothing like that. See, any holy name can deliver a person. Okay, it is not that if I chant only Krishna, I will get delivered. Suppose at the time of that if I chant Vittal, I will not get delivered. I will get delivered. It is not that it is generally mentioned Harinama Sankirtan. But what is that is, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he personally came and he came in the mood of Radharani and he suggested chant this Hare Krishna mantra because this has internal potency. Hare refers to Radharani, Krishna and Rama refers to again Krishna only. Okay, you pick this mantra so that the advancement will be more faster. Even the other names also, if you chant offenselessly, definitely you can go back to Godhead. But particularly if you chant this Hare Krishna mantra, the advancement will be more faster. But then it is not that way that if you chant some other names, see many Sri Vaishnavas, they will chant Vishnu Sahasranam. They will love. With tears I have seen, there are many devotees with tears, they will chant Vishnu Sahasranam. So, will they not go back to Godhead? They will definitely. Okay, but this Hare Krishna mantra, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Krishna himself suggested better follow that word. Because many names are there, everything we cannot do. Whatever works faster, better pick that one and go back. That Prabhu, answer? No clapping hands. Any other question?
Ajamila. That's what you said. At last, Ajamila remembered Narayana.
Mm.
And he said later he went to the
Haridwar.
At the end time only he chanted the Prabhu. How he went again to Haridwar?
So, what happened? He chanted the holy names of Narayana. Now, Vishnududas relieved him from the clutches of Yamadudas. Mm. Now, after that, he started weeping and crying.
Body or soul, Prabhu?
No,
he was still alive.
They gave a second chance to him. So Ajamila, now he has got the association of Vaishnavas. Vishnududas, Yamadudas. See, Yamadudas are also not like a sinful persons. They are messengers of Yama. They are doing their duty. They are obedient to their father. Okay? So they are. He has got the association of Vaishnavas. He heard the potency of the holy name. So association, hearing, now he started weeping and crying. He started weeping and crying and he realized what kind of sins he has done. So he chanted again, he started weeping and crying because he felt about himself bad again and again. All those sins already washed away for him. Then he went to Haridwar. Now he has seen the Vishnududas, right? Because that is what everyone is hankering to. See, so Vishnududas, the form is exactly like Vishnu. Right? Have you ever read Bhagavatam 4th canto? Dhruva Maharaj pastime? Actually, this Ajamila pastime is in 6th canto. So Dhruva Maharaj pastime, it is mentioned, it is given details in 4th canto. 4th canto, 2nd chapter or 3rd chapter, Dhruva Maharaj pastimes are given. So there, Narada Muni explains how Lord Vishnu, what is the form of Lord Vishnu in Vaikuntha. So first sloka Narada Muni explains, Prasadhabi mukam sasvat prasanna vadaneshanam sunanam subhruvam charu kapolam surasundaram. Prasadhabi mukam. Eternally the Lord is smiling. In our reality, only in Colgate advertisement we will see people smiling. But Lord, eternally he smiles in Vaikuntha. Prasadhabi mukam sasvat prasanna vadaneshanam sunanam subhruvam charu kapolam. His forehead is very beautiful and it's very broad. Like that, and in further slokas, Narada Muni explains, Kiritinam kundalinam keyura vadayanvitam kaustubha bharanagrivam pita kausyega vasasam. So, how Lord has decorated himself. He is wears the exactly folded yellow dhoti. So, how he is wearing kiritam, kundalam, ornaments, everything he is wearing. So, exactly, Vishnududas also look like similar to Lord. Only one difference. Vishnududas will not have Srivatsa mark. Srivatsa mark means it's kind of a white curl here in the chest of the Lord. Vishnududas will not have. But almost same form. So after seeing that form, now the mind completely got attracted to that form. So he went to Haridwar, he started meditating on the form of the Lord. And finally the same Vishnududas came. They took him back to Vaikuntha. Not that immediately he went. They gave a second chance to him. So there are 6 slokas. Narada Muni explains about the bodily futures of Lord Vishnu. And Narada Muni says, not the only request, Dhruva, meditate on this sloka and try to sit in meditation. Okay, so by meditating these slokas, at least approximately we can try to remember the form of the God. Okay, any other questions? So we will stop here.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.